eat the pork. We ready to do all. You know what the Bible say don't do? The Bible say don't speak in tongues. Oh, Lord. Okay. Oh, come on, come on, come on, come on. Okay, sorry about that. We almost done. It says, verse 21, those who were in charge of that unlawful sacrifice took the man aside because of their long acquaintance with him. These people knew Eleazar. They knew that he was leading God's people at that time. He was the most, probably like the oldest and the most noble. But listen to what it says. And privately urged him to bring meat of his own providing, proper for him to use, and to pretend that he was eating the flesh of the sacrificial meat that had been commanded by the king. This is King Dionysus. Y'all know King Dionysus. He probably related to Prometheus, Lord Prometheus. You know them kings over there. They wanted these people to celebrate. Oh, honey. Honey, 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 real quick, real quick. They wanted these people to celebrate the king. I skipped down to Eleazar, but I'm going to go back to chapter this, verse 7 real quick. On the monthly celebration of the king's birthday, the Jews were taken under bitter constraint to partake of. Now, if these was these Jews over there, honey, they be talking about their history. Ain't nobody talking about this stuff. They could care less about this stuff right here. Why? Because God says, if you people who are called by my name don't obey me, I'm going to give my statutes, my commandments, my name, my blessings to other people who will. And that's how we got to, it's right here in your Bible. I got the verses, they all right here in your Bible. God said this in the book. He said the people he was talking to in Deuteronomy 28, chapter 28, he said, Moses, you tell them, I command them this day. You either hearken to my voice and you get the blessing, or you hearken to my voice and you get the curse. Let me tell you something. Some of us, like Eleazar, didn't want to follow these people. And they stood in the blessing. Some of us went the Bible say whoremonging, fornicating, idolatry. That's what all of this is talking about. That's what all of this is. That's where we get all this from. Listen to what they did. It says, on the monthly celebration of King's birthday, the Jews were taken under bitter constraint to partake of the sacrifices. And when a festival of Dionysus was celebrated, they were compelled to wear wreaths of ivy and to walk in the procession in honor of Dionysus. They had to get their butts out there and march for a king that wasn't even Christ, the high priest. They had to go out there because, see, everybody, when Christ came on the face of the earth and left, all these people wanted to be the high priest. That's why the Pope over there now being the high pontifex, the high priest. There's some truth to this, people. Listen, it says, at the suggestion of the people, Palladius, a decree was issued to the neighboring Greek cities that they should adopt the same policy toward the Jews and make them partake in the sacrifices. So every other little city around there got the ordinance and the okay to treat all the Jews like this, okay? And then it goes on to say, right here, hold on. And should kill those who do not choose to change over to Greek customs. Who the hell want to be a Greek? And right today, you still serving Greek customs with your Christianity. This stuff is real, people. It just said it right there. I'm a black woman serving Greek customs, speaking a European language after the queen. Go figure. That, if that ain't trying to confuse you, who you is, who you was with God, who you were in the Bible, I don't know what is. They're confusing the masses, and they've done it. But thank God we bright enough to say, wait, pastors, wait, preachers, wait, teachers, something ain't right. Something is not right. And then it just says here, oh, No. I'm almost done. Okay, guys, almost there. Thank you guys so much. Okay, so it says, you heard that. They want you to follow Greek customs. That's where Jesus' name come from. That's a Greek name. And they put it like so close to Zeus. That's who they want to serve in Jerusalem. Ain't no other God but God and Christ gonna sit in Jerusalem. That's all that hell breaking out over there now. These people over there know what time it is with this religion and with this truth that they don't want us to know. When I went on the United States Catholic Bishop's website and I seen the same information there, I said, what the hell else they got hiding under the Vatican basement? They got some truth over there. And for the love of God, I'm going to get there one day. You're going to reach out. Somebody going to be able to sit down with the Pope and ask this stuff. Because he's the ruler of the religion, right? He allow a lot of this stuff to go on. I'm not saying the Pope in general, the entity. Because, you know, they pass the baton down year after year, generation after generation, Pope after Pope. They know the truth. But listen, it goes on to talk about, okay, it says publicly, for example, this is how bad it was when people didn't want to follow the Greek customs. I'm going to just give you one example. One could see, therefore, that misery that had come upon them. For example, two women brought in for having circumcised their children. Now, we know all America circumcised their baby boy on the eighth day. That came from the Bible. That came from the children of Israel. That came from God, Abraham. I know the Bible say whether you circumcise, uncircumcised, that's why you circumcise your babies on the eighth day. Okay? It's biblical. It's in here. You had two women following God's custom going to circumcise their baby, right? And look what it says. It says, for example, two women brought in for having circumcised their children. They publicly paraded them around the city with their babies hanging at their breasts and then hurled them down headlong from the wall. This is how we was being treated. This is how I'm being treated now because I want to go back to God's customs. This is how these people were being treated, yo. I get passionate because I look out in the world today and I see so many people trying to serve God the right way and all these Christians want to bash people. Do your goddamn research, okay? And I said, God is not his name. God is just a title. I'm sick of people getting it confused. I'm not sitting here blaspheming the Lord. I'm telling you people, stop taking the word of God and putting what you want to put out there. Give people the damn truth. Because you got some people still out here today trying to follow the word of God and we getting crucified just like Christ did. But answer this. Did he get killed on the cross or did they hang him on the tree? I could read to you right now in the book of Acts chapter 5 verse 30 through 32. It say that Peter witnessed him being hung from a tree. Now, somebody telling a damn lie. If the Bible can lie, and I'm not saying God's a liar, because I have the Holy Spirit in me. I have the anointing in me. I know it's true and what's not being spoken truthful right now today. And a lot of this stuff that's being preached in the church is not being truthful. I'm just going to take a brief intermission because I'm right here. And I'm going to go to the book of Acts. And I want y'all to hear this for yourself. We've been taught that he hung on the cross, right? And I keep telling y'all that the Roman people, these same Greek people, the instrument of torture that they use is the cross. They kill their criminals with a cross. So, I get passionate about this stuff, y'all. I'm sorry. Almost done, y'all. Almost done. Almost done. Almost done. So listen, I'm almost done, God. Read this for yourself. I'm not trying to put division nowhere in this world because it's already divided. I'm trying to shine light, set some truth apart from the lies so that people can get on the right course with God and walk out they work out their salvation, as the Bible say, with fear and trembling. With all the damn lies out here, you scared. You don't know what to believe, who to believe, what to trust. But you know, you heard they hung him high and stretched him wide on the cross, right? Peter says, right here, it says in Acts 5, let's just start with verse 28. Saying, did not we straightly command you that you should not teach in this name? In what name? Emmanuel? What? They couldn't teach in his name? He just got crucified or hung on the tree. We about to see. You be the judge. Let your faith decide. That's the whole thing. You see the topic? Jesus or Emmanuel? I proved to you in Isaiah 9 and 6 when they said, oh, a child is given to us. It listed some things. It didn't say Jesus there. When I read to you in Matthew 1:22-23, it says a child will be given to a virgin and his name shall be called what? What? Let me see if I can get this for y'all real quick. Hold on. Oh, where am I at? Where's my mouse? His name shall be called that right there. Not Jesus, okay? So far we on the right path. Listen to what this say. Did we not? Now, this the Pharisees, the scribes, and some other people now. These the church folks. These is the church folks saying, oh, didn't we tell you not to go in that name right there? This name. Church folks don't want you to go in this name right here. They want you to go in Jesus' name. Because not too far after Acts 5, when you go to Acts 11, that's when Peter, Paul, and the Romans, and the Grecians, and everybody else started the church. It's right there in chapter 11, verse 19. But we right here. These is the church folks telling the apostles of that day, saying, did not we straightly command you that you should not teach in this name? And behold, you have filled Jerusalem with your doctrine. What doctrine is that? Not the gospel of Christ. They were still probably preaching the kingdom of heaven. And these people were mad because they were still close. Remember, Acts 2 is when the Holy Spirit came down. We only three chapters behind that in chapter 5. And you got some people telling the disciples of Jesus, didn't we straightly tell you not to prophesy and talk and preach in his name? These people crazy, y'all. I'm not the crazy one. I'm crazy enough to sit here, though, and get into this Bible and help us see the truth. That's what I'm really crazy about and passionate. All my damn life, I've been a Christian. Well, 19 coming up. And all my damn life, it ain't a struggle. I have one of the most peaceful lives. When I say no drama, I get it from my daughter and my grandkids sometimes. I have no drama like that. If people got drama with me, that's their problem. I don't know about it. Keep it to yourself. I need drama from Christians. Come on. Come on back in here, y'all. Come on back in here. Come on back in here, y'all. Come on back in here. Come on back in here, y'all. Come on back in here. Come on, Facebook. Come on, come on, come on, Facebook. I'm praying for y'all to come back. Come on, Facebook. I apologize. Listen, I'm not out here deceiving you. I'm not out here lying to you. This is all in the Bible. Preachers don't preach this. Preachers don't teach this. Not too shortly after Christ left, you had people in the earth saying, didn't we tell you not to preach in that name? Let's go on. That's 28. It says, 28. Saying, did not we straightly command you that you should not teach in this name? What name would that be, y'all? And behold, you have filled Jerusalem with your doctrine and intend to bring this man's blood upon us. Okay? Listen to verse 29. Then Peter and the other apostles answered and said, we ought to obey God rather than men. Okay, so where do we get away from obeying God, people? Right here. Right here. Look, verse 30 says, the God of our fathers raised up. They got Jesus here. I'm going to say Yeshua. I'm going to say Emmanuel. Why not call the man by his name, whom ye slew and hanged on a tree? God damn it. Let me tell you something. There is 150-something odd references to trees in the Bible. There's 19 references to cross. God is very clear about the two words. I know we say wood is wood, oh, the wood. No, no, no. Very clear. He's very clear about the two. And I'm going to tell you why. Because you remember when Elijah wanted to die? What did Elijah do? Elijah ran to a tree to hang himself, right? Because he was ready to die. Is that not a prophecy of Christ being killed on the tree right here? And you remember when Judas, after he betrayed Christ, I think, but before or after Christ passed, he went to hang himself on the tree, right? Why would he go hang himself on the tree, y'all? Was it some kind of sympathy, some kind of regret that he betrayed Jesus and he wanted to die like Jesus did? Because see, it's in your Bible that people, when they was ready to die, it's in the Old Testament and it's in the New Testament. They didn't want to go to no cross to die. Mm-mm. They wanted to go to a tree. And then if you go, and this is a whole nother teaching, y'all. I got it worked out because you telling me he died on the cross. But right here, Peter said, you hung him on the tree. And then Peter go on to say, he had God exalted with his right hand and to be a prince and a savior. Not a Jesus. For to give repentance to who? The whole world? It say Israel. You figure out who Israel was then, and this is who Christ came for. I'm trying to tell you, we say, oh, Christ came for everybody. He even called the Syrophoenician woman a dog. He said, I didn't come for you. I came for the lost house, the lost sheep of Israel. She said, but master, I think he said something, you don't give the children's bread to dogs. She said, but master, even dogs eat from the crumbs from the master table. Just give me a little bit, Christ. Just give me a little bit. I have a daughter vexed with an evil spirit. I know you the Messiah. I know you came for the children of Israel. I know I'm a Gentile. There you go. Syrophoenician woman. She's not a Hebrew woman. She is a Gentile woman. Do you understand who the Gentile is? I'm not Syrophoenician. You may be Syrophoenician. It's some Greek people that's Christian. It's some Roman people that's Christian. Y'all is the Syrophoenician people. I'm not Syrophoenician. So she was the Gentile at that time. Anybody from Syrophoenician? Because Christ said, I didn't come for you, dog. Oh, you ain't know he called people dogs. He called them vipers and everything else. Because he's trying to get you to see the truth. Come on back up in here. Come on back up in here. Come on. Please come back up in. Please. All right, I apologize. We almost done. But guys, he called the woman a dog, stating to her, like, lady, look, I didn't come for you. I know I'm the Messiah. I know I can open. Look, Isaiah 61. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, he said, to set the captives free, open up blind eyes, heal the deaf, you know, bound and at liberty. That's what he walked the earth doing. And he opening my eyes right now. A long time I believed Christianity for what it was. You couldn't tell me. I'll be ready to argue with you. No, it's the truth. God started saying, what? Fall back, Drew. Fall back. I'm going to show you something. You say you want to serve me? Well, you better get in this word and you better study to show yourself approved unto God. So I need not be a workman and ashamed out here. When somebody asks me about this Bible, whether you think it's, how can Christ, that's the title for y'all guys. Christ can't die two ways. He can't. And neither can you. You can't die a sinner and you can't die a saint. You can't die unrighteous and you can't die. You got to die one or the other way. You're going to die righteous or you're going to die unrighteous. Christ can't die on the cross. And then right here in the book, Peter says, You hung them on a tree. You hung them on a tree. So I'm investigating that and asking God,